times in each show, we break the fourth wall, as they call it in the business, and let you in on a little of our personal lives. What we did over the weekend, maybe the latest movie we saw, but we don't talk about what is going on here in the studio behind the cameras. That is until today, when we are going to give you a peek behind the cameras with a few of the people who have joined us on the couch this year as co-host, Rain Jerky and Parker, and you probably haven't forgotten this guy yet, Gary Weckworth.
Hi.
Hello.
Hello.
It's good to have you all
well,
here.
I don't feel like I've been gone that long.
I know, it hasn't been that long, but we already miss you.
No, I'm grateful to come back to the anniversary show today.
Yes.
Don't forget, it's Elvis's birthday today, too.
Yes.
So.
We will never
forget
that. But
no, thank you all for having me back here today. Yeah. I'm glad Mrs. Gary Weckworth could be here too. So.
And I just want to mention, we did invite Stephanie Dinsmore as well, because she has filled in a lot, but she was not able to attend today.
So thanks for inviting us.
Yes, of course. But let's just get started. Gary, back to the beginning. Take us back to your first thoughts when you started with us. I was
really excited about it, because I really thought the format is kind of a cool idea. And to be able to have like an unscripted, but yet scripted, talk show, lifestyle program, I thought was kind of a neat idea. And so to be able to be a part of it early on was kind of exciting. But I haven't told you the story, but the first time I met you, I didn't really meet you. And so I knew I was potentially going to be your co-host. And I was down to Jane Andrews' office, who Jane's the executive producer of the show, and I was dropping off something or saying hi or doing whatever. And you were sitting in the chair.
At my desk.
At Jane's desk.
What?
You're sitting in Jane's desk, and I walked in just to say hi to Jane, and she said something. I knew I wasn't going to be here really quick, but Jane didn't acknowledge much, and she didn't turn around and introduce me to you, and who knows if I was even, formally announced that I was going to be your co-host. But you just kind of sat there like I didn't even exist.
Okay.
Usually people turn around and say like, oh, who's that? Oh, hi, nice to meet you. I'm Brittany. And you just kind of sat there. I'm like, who's this little snob?
But let's get things straight. When I am at my desk, and you can vouch for me, you too, Rain, in the morning too, when I'm getting prepared and I'm focusing on something, I am so dialed in that people could be talking to me and I will not even hear them. People will be walking behind me, I won't even notice it, because I'm just so dialed into what I'm doing. But I didn't really know until we actually sat down together and read scripts, like who you were or that you were a possible candidate. I was kind of out of the loop with all of that, but.
Yeah.
And that's so opposite from how you are in real life.
She's not that way. No,
she's Brittany, not that way at all. Just warm and
hopefully over the last
friendly.
Year you've seen that, because Brittany and I have become really good friends and we enjoy each other's company, and we've had a lot of fun doing this together.
Yeah, we did.
So, yeah.
We had so much fun. Okay, so then we started off this January 8th, 2018, a year ago. And in the first 3 weeks, I had gotten sick. I lost my voice on the Friday show, and then over the weekend it just kept progressing and I got super, super sick. So already in the first 3 weeks, I'm freaking out, thinking, oh my gosh, I cannot miss a show this early. Right. We just started. And so last minute they called Anne. You had an hour's notice.
it was short.
So what is going through your head at this point?
It was short. Well, first of all, I just, in my head, I was like, oh no, it's been too long. And then I said, well, I've got to do it. Okay, so I think the one benefit was that I didn't have a lot of notice in the end, because I didn't have a lot of time to think about it. The one thing I did think about, though, was in the last 30 years since I've done this before, high-definition television shows every little pore and everything. I said, okay, so I have aged just a little bit in the last 30 years, but it was nothing to worry about, and Jane reassured me. And
for those that don't know, Ann and I, and because her name came up as Ann Parker, but Ann and I are husband and wife. We've been that way for a long time, 35 years, right?
But we used to
sit on this same spot.
We
and did the
right
noon
here.
News
they
back
were the
in
little
the
lovebirds
early
at noon.
And so it had been
hands under the table.
Yeah, no, we didn't do that.
Came full circle.
Yeah, so we did that for a few years together. So it was kind of fun and ironic that we were able to come back.
That's really
and then
neat.
Do it again together.
What a great gift that was.
Yeah,
right.
Really
awesome. Just come back.
I only did it a couple of times, but it was
we had fun.
It was really a great memory and a great opportunity to be able to do that one more time.
And we'll never forget the bacon bombs recipe that you taught
bacon
us.
Bombs were good. I like the bacon bombs.
Bacon. So.
Yes.
Bacon with everything.
Yeah.
We knew that show would be successful because of the bacon.
Yeah. Exactly, exactly. And then Rain, so you've kind of been here since the beginning too as well. You've filled in a lot over the different amounts of months that have come by. And so what would you say that you, from when you first started and how the show has changed up till now?
I just really like how the show's progressed within the community, and it exposes everybody's businesses and the charities and the different foundations that are out there, and we really get to learn more about what's going on in our community. You know, I was mentioning earlier that we kind of get focused on our daily lives, going to work and then going home, spending time with our family and our kids, and we don't really get to know the world around us and the people around us. And I feel like it helps us build those relationships with the community and get to learn so much more than just at face value. And that's the coolest thing that I've seen in the show. I'm really honored to be a part of it.
And a lot of people know that you are a performer. You've been in a band, you do plays and things like that. But you've never done television really. So what was your first thoughts going into this? Kind of a different avenue.
Yeah, I think much like Anne, you know, at first you don't want to get in your head, and you just kind of jump in and let it be natural, you know, and I try to just kind of be myself and be a little goofy and just enjoy it. And it's been an interesting experience. I don't have TV experience per se, but I've just really enjoyed getting to learn this side of the camera.
And for me personally, coming into this, I feel I went through probably one of the biggest changes of my life, because when I got the job offer and it was a lifestyle show host, I was like, this is my dream job. This is what I've always wanted to do with my life. And I think I was just so happy and so excited. But then I look back and I'm like, wait, I didn't even know what the show was. I didn't know the title of the show. I didn't even know I was having a co-host. I knew nothing. I packed up my bags.
Well, that was obvious when you showed up.
Right, exactly.
Yeah, right? I packed up my bags. I moved to Sioux Falls. I found out I got the job in like the last day of September, and I moved here the end of October. So I packed up my bags. I moved to Sioux Falls, bought a house, and it didn't even feel like it wasn't supposed to happen, or I wasn't nervous about it. It was like I just put my faith in God and trusted this plan. But like looking back, I'm like, wow, I really had no idea what was going on with this show or anything about it. But I knew, and I was here for a month before we even knew Gary was coming in. We didn't have the associate producer Kayla yet. And so I'd been here for a month, and then in December we started getting the show format, and it kind of all started to come together. But then even in our first rehearsal week, things ran so smoothly. Mm-hmm. And it was kind of crazy that it went so well, because none of us had any experience with a show like this. Mm-hmm. And so that was super fun to see. But then even as time goes on, there's little changes we make. There's always something that Jane's calling up to the director's booth saying, so we have another new thing we're gonna try. Yeah. Is this gonna work? And so it's fun to constantly see all of that. And we started with 6 segments, now we do 5 segments a day. So that's always been my favorite part, in getting to meet so many people in the community. And we are storytellers and sharers, and we get to share their stories. And it's so rewarding to be a part
of all. Ignorance is bliss, is what they say, right? When you first jumped in.
Right, right. Yeah.
And then the best things in life happen when you take a leap of faith.
Exactly.
Absolutely.
And it was at the best time in my life, and I wouldn't change it for the world. This community has become home so fast, and it's because of all of you guys. So.
Yeah, exactly.
Yeah.
So.
Well, what would a first birthday be without a smash cake or a giant cookie? We still have some show left for today, so the smash cake was out, unfortunately. But we do have the next best thing.
Okay.
Rain's gonna grab it here quick.
We have a happy first anniversary cake.
Yes, so seriously though, our first year wouldn't be the success it has been without you, our viewers. So thank you to you, and we'll take a bite in your honor. Yeah. I'm not really sure we can take a bite unless we just nibble on the corner, so we'll probably dish up in a little bit.
We can dig into it.